Hi, my name is Reagan Bramley. I'm a student at Missouri Southern State University studying business education, and today my TED Talk is going to be about the digital divide. The digital divide is a worldwide issue that affects students of low-income areas and in poverty. According to a study done by Pew Research, 15% of U.S. students don't have access to high-speed internet within their household. But this doesn't only affect students in the U.S. Another study done by Khan Academy showed that countries such as Chad, Nigeria, and Pakistan have an internet usage of 20 to 30%, while countries such as Sweden, Norway, and Saudi Arabia have 80 to 100% usage. That's a good example. You can see how big the gap is from more advanced countries to the more impoverished countries. A recent study done by Pew Research Center during this pandemic showed that 43% of lower-income students whose schools have been closed down are doing their homework on their cell phones. So they're checking their grades, they're writing papers, they're checking in with their teachers all from their mobile phone. 22% of students are using public Wi-Fi such as McDonald's or Starbucks, and 21% are not able to do their homework at all. So 21% of our students here in the U.S. are not getting an education. We don't know when this pandemic is going to be over, so how long are we going to go with letting 20% of our students not getting an education? And the older students, they're able to drive themselves to places such as McDonald's and Starbucks to use public Wi-Fi. But the younger ones, early ages, they're not getting that opportunity, that education. So schools such as the San Antonio district were able to give all 50,000 of their students a laptop or device. While this is really good and is a step towards closing that gap, not all of these 50,000 students have access to internet to connect these devices to and connect to their schools. So for a lot of students, they may be useless or they may just be something to play games on, but not used for educational purposes. So my proposition for closing this gap is government or organizationally funded internet and devices. Organizations such as Close the Gap take donated devices and they redonate them to other countries for social and educational projects. Once again, the device is just half the problem. It's great to expose these countries to the technology and help them learn about it, but the real problem is the internet connection, because you can't Google anything, you can't download anything without Wi-Fi. So there are companies such as Cable TV and Xfinity that are offering low-income households a cheaper alternative to their average $60 a month Wi-Fi package. But they still do have to pay for it. They still have to make the appointment, pay for it to get set up in their house, pay for the router. And a lot of parents don't have time for this. So my proposition is free Wi-Fi for all, using towers and antennas to broadcast it among cities. Proof that this is possible, Brooklyn Library System, they noticed during the pandemic a lot of people just sitting outside of their library using their Wi-Fi while their doors were shut due to COVID-19. Their plan is to put antennas on top of their buildings to project their Wi-Fi 300 feet in a 300 feet perimeter of their building so that people can have access to this Wi-Fi. Although it is a small scale, it's definitely progression, and it's proof that it is possible to cast it for everybody to have free Wi-Fi. And the reason I think the government should be responsible for this is they're the ones that have shut down our states, shut down our schools, shut down our jobs, and they're just sending students home to just have a virtual education. But virtual education takes devices, it takes internet. And as I said before, 43% are doing it on their phone. 20% are not even doing their homework. They're not even connecting to their classrooms. And this is a serious problem. And if this pandemic progresses and we are still in this situation for the long haul, then we need to fix this so that our students can get the education that they deserve.